All right, so first thing is safety. If you have your lanyards or long hair or like baggy clothes or sleeves that came down, you want to make sure that you take all of those things off because this, it's going to be spinning kind of fast. So if you're like leaning over and your lanyard gets caught in here, it's not really good.
Can you die?
I mean, probably.
You turned around. Got it.
Yeah, we don't want to. No, I don't even want to think about that. Same with hair. Like, if it's going fast, it could just like rip your hair out. If it's going kind of slow, it could get like tangled.
Yeah, your face on it.
Yeah. So, but
has that ever happened here?
Here, no. When I was in college, though, it happened to a girl. She had long hair and like ripped out like a chunk at her temple. Also earbuds. If you have earbuds in and those are like dangling, those can like rip out so fast that they like damage the inside of your ear. You don't want to do that either. Okay, so when you're growing, you need water, sponge, and then you'll need needle, wooden knife, wooden rib, and wire, which is over there. Would you mind grabbing my wire for me? And then these are optional, like other ribs. Thank you. And if you get another bat and put it underneath, that way you can put all your scraps there and all your tools, and that's really easy to pick up and clean instead of having to come back and clean the wheel. So this is the wheel. The silver part is the wheel head. These are called bat pins, because they hold your bat. And the pedal is not like a car pedal. If you turn it on and you take your foot off, it stays where you kept the pedal. So you actually have to turn it off with your foot. Does that make sense? So, when you're working on the wheel, the whole point is the wheel is doing most of the work for you. So if I need to clean this and scrape off some of this, am I going to sit here and like do this? No. I'm going to turn the wheel on, and I'm going to hold my hand in one place to get all that off. And same thing with the sponge. Yeah, I guarantee someone will be like this.
That's something I would do.
Yeah. So, wheel does the work, and still, and you need to dampen your bat before you start, whether it's clean or not. Just get it here. And you could just do this, like I love doing this. So, wheel, it's like a clock. And your hands are almost always going to be within 2 and 6. So like this area right here. So the wheel is spinning. If I'm at 3 o'clock with my sponge, I'm just barely holding onto it. The wheel is like gliding right underneath. I don't feel any resistance at all. It's fine. But as soon as I go over to the other side, see how it like starts catching it? Pulling it away, you don't want that. You want the clay to just fly through your fingers. So always stay on this side. Does that make sense? So when you're throwing, it's gonna feel really awkward at first, but you want your chair all the way up against the wheel. You're gonna have your legs around the splash pan, and you're always gonna have your elbows like in your thighs, on your side, on your knees, on your legs, somewhere, because your arms are always gonna be in. And then you're always going to be like looking directly down to the center. So you're going to be like hunched over like this. Not like this, because I promise you'll just be like doing nothing. And you'll get sad and cry, and then you'll quit. So you're always like, think like compact, like you're like small, okay? So once you're ready, you're just going to set your ball of clay in the middle. And then you're going to tap center. So you're just kind of like gently eyeballing it and trying to get it as close to the middle as you can. And then I kind of just pat it a couple times to make sure that it's stuck. Because if it's not stuck, then it will like fly off. Since you kind of have it on there, then you'll use your finger. And you want to just seal where the clay and the bat meet, and that way the water doesn't get underneath. All right, so the first step to throwing anything is centering. And this is, to me, the hardest part. What do you think? Is this the hardest part? Yeah. So when you're trying to throw with clay, let me see if I can get this real quick. When you're throwing with clay and you're trying to make like a cylinder, you have like the walls or the sides of the cylinder, right? And so if your clay is centered, it's really easy to get even walls. It's centered. Now, if your clay is not in the middle, and you try and do something, it's gonna be uneven, it's not gonna work, it's just gonna collapse on itself. So you have to center it. And there's a ton of different ways that you can do it, like where your hands are positioned and all that. But essentially what you're doing is you are pushing the clay away from you in one direction. So the only way it can go is that direction towards the center and up. So you can see I'm just pushing, like I'm starting at the very bottom right here with my hands. And all I'm doing is pushing away from myself this way. And you can see it's just moving up by itself. And then, so now I'm pushing away, and then now I'm curling my other fingers around to kind of help it. Pushing away from myself, and I'm getting it into a cone. So this is called coning up and down. And this just helps you center because you're gonna center from the top down. And so you're only trying to work with a small amount of clay instead of all of it at once. So you'll do this a couple times because you can see it's still wobbling, so it's not quite centered. So I'm gonna start at the top, and then now I'm pressing down so the clay can only go down, and I'm still pushing towards the center. Those are the only places it can go. And so that's forcing the clay to be in the center. So you can see this top part looks like it's still, it's not moving. And when I put my finger on it, my finger doesn't move. So that's how you know it's centered. Now when I get down here, not quite the same thing. Pressing down. You always want to try and keep a like a dome shape where it's smaller at the top and gets bigger at the bottom. More time. I have an air bubble down there, so we'll see how this goes. Any questions about centering? So that's another reason why you want to wedge your clay. If you have air bubbles, that makes it off center. And one thing that you'll have to kind of play around with is how much water to use. If you can feel the clay and it feels like rough and it's catching on your hands, you need more water. But you also don't want to like take a whole handful and just throw that on there because that's that's too much. And I've literally had people. I've had a student like bring another little cup and dip the cup and just like pour water. You don't need that much. Well, if you use too much water, it starts going everywhere, and then your splash pan will start to fill up and get above the line, and then it'll start leaking everywhere. So if that happens, you're using too much water. So now that I have it centered somewhat, it's still not at the bottom. Now I need to sink the hole, or make the opening that I'm going to use to make the bottom and then make the sides. So you're not just going to stick your finger down in the center. You can see how I can't really keep it in the middle. To make sure that it's centered, you can use your thumbs. So I'm just like have them at an angle, and I'm just pressing straight down. You can also use your your fingers on your right hand. And again, I'm not just going straight down. I have them at like a V, and I'm just pressing my whole hand down. And then, so once you do that, you want to check the bottom, how thick it is. So you'll stick your needle in, put your finger where the clay is, and you can see mine's a little thin. You want it to be about half to a fourth of an inch. This is too much. Inch is too much. About the same as your slabs. So now you have this V shape, and now we need to open it so the bottom is flat. So you're going to use the same fingers, and now I'm just like hooking them and then dragging them towards my other hand on the outside. Does that make sense? And then you just use your fingers to smooth it. Make sure it's flat and even. And then now, your goal is to take this big ring and this big chunk of clay, and you're trying to squeeze it so it only has one way to go, and that's up. What time is it? Anybody?
11:48.
Oh. How much do y'all have to clean up? Do you have any clay out? No, you don't. Do you? What do you have? So to make the walls, you're squeezing from the inside and the outside, basically. And you have this like ring of clay that you're squeezing in and bringing upward.
So is it harder than it looks or easier than it looks?
I'll have a couple of students who this comes naturally to, but it's harder than it looks. So again, I'm pushing from the outside and the inside to make this ring of clay right there. And then that's what I'm going to grab onto. I'm squeezing and just kind of pulling up at the same time. And then by the time I get up to the top, I haven't done anything. I'm not just... And you want these to be the same thickness as the bottom. There's that air bubble. Dang it. See it? So if you don't wet your clay and you have an air bubble, that happens. It'll pop, and then you'll have a thin spot, and it'll just collapse. Sad.
What?
Oh, that worked for nothing.
So you had to start all over?
Yep, that's why you make more than one.
What the?
That's why you make more than one. So.
No, I want to start. I don't got patience for this. I had to make 10 balls.
I quit after like two. I'd be too mad.
Miss Davies couldn't even do it. Oh no.
You don't think I mess up? I mess up all the time. The difference between me and you is I don't want to bother me. I know that's part of it.
It bothers me. I don't do it right the first. I have to do it right the first.
Grabbing that ring. Moving it up. That makes sense, at least, mm-hmm. What I've shown you so far.
You can do it a lot faster without having to explain it.
Okay. So once you have pulled it and the walls are the right thickness, now you have all this extra clay down here that you need to get rid of. So you're going to use the wooden knife and you're going to hold it parallel to the side, and then you're just going to go straight down. And then you will use your needle to go underneath it and cut it off. And then you'll use your wooden rib to kind of clean up the outside. The outside looks okay, but like the other one, if I hadn't lost it, I would have cleaned it up. And you just hold the rib on the outside. It's not doing anything, but your fingers on the inside and they're pushing the clay towards the rib.
Just to make it like flat?
Yeah, to flatten it out and just to straighten it up. And then you will get all of the extra clay on the bottom. Not clay, water. Make sure your rim is good. And then you need to cut it off the bat. So what you have to do is called making an undercut, and that's just making a little place for the wire to go underneath. So again, your wooden knife, and you just hold it at an angle at the bottom, just to make that little undercut. And then to cut it off, you can either pull the wire towards you, away from you. You can have the wheel spinning slowly or still. Just whatever kind of feels right for you. You just want to make sure that you always have the wire like pressed down to the bat really well. And then you would take it off. Even though this is the fast one. Oh yeah. The bottom is a little too thick. So you can see how the bottom is thick. But the sides are pretty even. About 90 degrees a little. It's okay.
So what'd you
cut it?
Just to show.
No, you have to cut all your pots. And then you like score and slip them back together.
Yeah, so I was like, wait, what? What was all this for?
Alright. Thank y'all. Do you have any questions?